Hi guys and welcome to TechBased. In this video we're gonna talk about the disk space in Windows 11 and how to clean up the disk space. If you have a full Windows 11 partition, you would want to clean up the space because if you have a full partition, that could affect performance. Even in gaming, you could have lag spikes because of this. So basically I have an example here. We have a Windows 11 installed on a 21 gigabytes partition. And in this video, we're gonna try to use only the tools that Microsoft provides within Windows 11 to free up as much space as we can in order to clean up the space and make more space available for our usage. And of course, to let Windows 11 breathe and be able to run properly. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna click on the search box and type in here settings and click on it. You can pin settings on your taskbar very easily by right-clicking on it and then pin to taskbar. I'm doing this because it's really simple and easier to access it. And that's very useful if you go into the settings app pretty often. Here in the system section, go down a bit and click on storage. And here, as you can see, Windows 11 will automatically analyze how much apps and features use from our Windows operating system and also temporary files. In Windows 11, we can find here Storage Sense, which is basically a tool that automatically frees up space, deletes temporary files, and manages locally available cloud content. But I don't really recommend using this. I recommend you manually deleting and selecting what Windows 11 should delete. So as you can see here, we have 300 megabytes of temporary files. If we click on it, we can see here what those temporary files consist of. As you can see, Windows Update Cleanup, downloads, which is not selected, thumbnails, and so on and so forth. If you don't have downloads selected, you can also go into this PC and look here and see what you have in downloads. If you don't need anything from here, you can delete it. So that's what I'm gonna do. Basically select everything from here if you are up to it. Of course, I strongly recommend you to read everything from here and make sure you don't delete anything important or anything that you need. So I'm just gonna click on remove files and then click on continue. As you saw there, it warned us because the downloads folder was also included, but we checked and nothing important was deleted because we didn't have anything important in the downloads folder. So now wait a bit, purging Windows Update Cleanup, and basically it will go on and delete everything from here. Windows Update Cleanup, as you can see, has a whole bunch of files, and as you can see here, Windows keeps copies of all installed updates from Windows Update. You should go and delete these once in a while because they take up a lot of space actually. And as you can see, the process is completed and we can actually see some results. We've cleaned up almost 1 gigabyte of storage, and that's pretty good. So let's see what we can do next. We're gonna go back. We're gonna go to apps and features and see which apps we actually don't use from here. Of course, I'm on a VM now, so I won't go and uninstall any apps because I don't have any big apps. But if you have apps that you no longer use and they take up a lot of space, I strongly recommend you clicking on these three dots next to it and then clicking on uninstall, because it will help you clean up the space. Down here in storage management, we have cleanup recommendations. Basically here we have cleanup recommendations that we can run once in a while, but now we cannot run it because we've already done a cleanup of our system. We've cleaned up temporary files and so on and so forth. So that's really good. What we've done so far is basically the most important things that we can do in order to clean up space. But if you click on show more categories, you'll see here all the categories that your space is divided in. And basically the system and reserved is the biggest one because we have the system files, the reserved storage, and virtual memory. Basically, this is system files that are very important and they help Windows run properly. We have apps and features here, as you can see. So as I've said, if you have any big apps that you no longer use, you can go here and uninstall apps as well. And we have these other categories: temporary files, other, mail, documents, pictures, music, videos, OneDrive, desktop, and maps. If you have a computer that you've used for, let's say, almost a year, you'll see here in the other categories space to clean up as well. So that's how you can clean up your disks or your storage from Windows 11, only using the tools that Microsoft provides within the settings app of Windows 11. And of course, by clicking on any of these categories, you will be able to see the files, see their size, and of course, you're gonna have the option to delete them if you no longer need them and stuff like that. So basically in this video, from nothing, we've managed to save up 1 gigabyte of storage. I'm sure that you will manage to do better because you will have a lot more files, a lot more temporary files compared to me, because I've only had this machine for a month now. So I'm sure that you will manage to free up 10 gigs plus from your storage. And as I've said at the beginning of this video, let Windows 11 breathe out and be able to use the space that it needs in order to run properly and with no crashes, no lag spikes and stuff like that. I'm hoping this video is useful. Don't forget to leave a like down below if the video helped you, and also don't forget to subscribe to the TechBased channel with the notification bell activated so that you won't miss any future uploads like this one. I was Emmanuel from TechBased. Until next time, have a nice day.